During the 1960s and 1970s, many environmentalists attempted to collect a number of people to restore the rainforests, endangered species, and many other environmental problems. The environmentalists began by advertising through public projects, posters, radio announcements, and public service announcements through television, which many people watched in these time periods. One of the major environmentalists of the time was an author by the name of Rachel Carson, who wrote the book Silent Spring, explaining the environmental pollution hazard of chemical pesticides, mainly DDT. She explained that not only was this a hazardous chemical for the air and plants, but also for the consumers of the pesticided products. Using this type of media was very effective at the end of using pesticides on produce. But the problem of pesticides was only a pebble taken out of the polluted river of problems. The next hope to save the environment was to reduce the population of nuclear power plants. The power plants were used to create oil and gas for automobiles and planes. The main problem to nuclear plants was the destruction of the ozone and air capacity of the 100-mile radius towns near the power plants. Thanks to some of the same tactics of the fight for environmental change, with Barry Commoner writing a book called The Closing Circle. During the time of environmental change, the existing federal agencies came together to create the Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA. The EPA was formed to help to concern and alert the public of the harsh pollution of the land, air, and water of the earth. The EPA also helped to pass the Clean Air Act and the Clean Water Act. The Clean Air Act, passed in 1970, was designed to control air pollution and the pollutants who started the problems. Like the Clean Air Act, the Clean Water Act, passed in 1972, was created to regulate the discharge of industrial and municipal wastewater.